Museo Casa Enzo Ferrari, Enzo Ferrari's birthplace museum, includes the restored house where he was born and a new futuristic automotive design gallery with a yellow cover, designed by the architect Gian Caplicchi. It is located in Modena. The birthplace hosts a permanent exhibition on the life of Ferrari's founder Enzo, while the gallery houses temporary exhibitions of vintage cars. The museum opened 10th March 2012. From 18th February 2024, the Enzo Ferrari Museum in Modena presents to visitors the new exhibition, Ferrari One of a Kind, a true celebration of the uniqueness that characterizes every masterpiece that leaves the gates of Maranello. A journey that shows the public the exclusivity of one-of-a-kind pieces created over time with the aim of expressing the personalities, tastes, and desires of Ferrari customers. Ferrari 330 P4. 1967 was a banner year for the Enzo Ferrari Motor Company as it saw the production of the mid-engined 330 P4, a V12 engined endurance car intended to replace the previous year's 330 P3. Only four Ferrari P4 engine cars were ever made. Their three-valve cylinder head was modeled after those of Italian Grand Prix winning Formula One cars. Ferrari One of a Kind offers a particular installation that on the one hand maximizes the extraordinary cars on display, often never seen before by the general public, and on the other shows in an immersive way the customization programs that Ferrari customers have access to. The heart of the exhibition will be an interactive wall where visitors can have a physical experience of the materials, fabrics, colors, and the vast quantity of options that the Ferrari Style Center makes available to customers eager to access these exclusive programs. The Ferrari F12 TDF, Tour de France model, is a track-focused version of the F12 Berlinetta unveiled in October 2015. The name pays homage to the Tour de France automobile race held between 1899 and 1986, and which was regularly won by the Ferrari 250 between 1956 and 1964. The F12 TDF shares the same 6.3-liter V12 engine with the F12 Berlinetta, but with power output increased to 780 PS. The F12 TDF is 110 kilogal lighter than the F12, having a claimed dry weight of 1,415 kilogal and curb weight of 1,520 kilos. Ferrari claims an acceleration time for the F12 TDF of 0 to 100 km/h in 2.9 seconds. The top speed was claimed to be in excess of 340 km/h. The car has recorded a 1 minute 21 seconds lap time on Ferrari's Fiorano test circuit, 2 seconds faster than the standard F12 Berlinetta and 488 GTB, and just 1.3 seconds behind the fastest lap set by the LaFerrari. F12 TDF was designed by Ferrari Styling Center. Production of the F12 TDF was limited to 799 units. Ferrari P80 C-Track car. One extremely well-heeled customer is about to receive the most radical one-off car in Ferrari's illustrious history, the P80 C. Designed as a modern take on the classic 330 sports car prototype with elements of the 1966 Dino 206S, the P80 C is a track-only monster that features the latest in Ferrari's formidable engineering. The project began in 2015, starting with the 488 GT3 as a platform, meaning it has the twin-turbo V8 and 7-speed dual-clutch gearbox of the original, along with a similar interior, or lack thereof. That's where the similarities end, as the P80C has completely original bodywork that emphasizes style and aerodynamic performance beyond even the 488 GT3. From the concave windshield to the aluminum pillars over the engine bay, and a completely exposed rear that shows all the glorious mechanicals, the P80C is easily the most aggressive one-off Ferrari has made. Ferrari Testarossa Type F110 is a 12-cylinder mid-engine sports car manufactured by Ferrari, which went into production in 1984 as the successor to the Ferrari Berlinetta Boxer. The Pininfarina designed car was originally produced from 1984 until 1991, with two model revisions following the end of Testarossa production called the 512TR and F512M. Which were produced from 1992 until 1996. Including revised variations, almost 10,000 cars in total were produced, making it at the time one of the most mass-produced Ferrari models. The Testarossa is a two-door coupe that premiered at the 1984 Paris Auto Show. All versions of the Testarossa were available with a rear-mounted 5-speed manual transmission. Ferrari has created a true oddball of a supercar. The 812 GTS is the first series production front-engine V12-powered spider that the marque has produced in half a century. And instead of creating a true GT cruiser, they've gone balls to the wall, the end result being a close-on 800 HP monster that will outpace nearly everything on the road, even with its top down. The 812 GTS benefits from all of the tech goodies that make cars like the F8 Tributo and 488 Pista such great cars. You get standard Brembo carbon ceramic brakes, adaptive suspension, performance-biased aero, and a V12 engine that will go down in the history books as one of the very best ever created. The 812 GTS is surprisingly easy to live with, and if you're single, it should prove to be adequate for daily city driving missions. Offered here is one of the first of Ferrari's 70th anniversary cars to be announced. Featured at the 2016 Paris Motor Show alongside an F12 Berlinetta, a California T, and a 488 GTB in different liveries, the livery on this 488 Spider was dubbed the Green Jewel. Inspired by David Piper's 365 P2, which won the Kyalami 9 Hours in 1965 and 1966, the car is outfitted with a number of unique features from the tailor-made department. These include metallic green paintwork, roundels on the door with number 25, larger airbrushed Scuderia shields and gold wheels. The special features continue inside with a duotone Nero and Rosso interior trimmed in richer Siam furniture leather, as well as aluminium and carbon fiber trim for a sportier appearance. Arguably the most recognizable of the 70th anniversary liveries.
cars.
An old workshop with the words Officina, Mechanica, Alfredo Ferrari across its frontage. The latter belonged to Ferrari's father, Alfredo, and operated as a small foundry supplying cast iron to the Italian National Railway. It was also the birthplace of Enzo. A number of Ferrari engines are on display in the workshop, as well as a rotating collection of race and road cars in the ultra-modern wing of the museum, completed in 2012. The collection ranges from a single-cylinder prototype for the team's 1992 F1 engine to the car that took Ferrari's 100th F1 win in the hands of Alain Prost in 1990. But arguably, the most interesting artifacts are found in the display cabinets lining the walls of the main workshop, including a pair of his distinctive dark glasses and a sample of his handwriting, notable and instantly recognizable by the vivid purple ink he always used. SF90, the car's name encapsulates the true significance of all that has been achieved in terms of performance. The reference to the 90th anniversary of the foundation of Scuderia Ferrari underscores the strong link that has always existed between Ferrari's track and road cars. A brilliant encapsulation of the most advanced technologies developed in Maranello, the SF90 is also the perfect demonstration of how Ferrari immediately transitions the knowledge and skills it acquires in competition to its production cars. Ferrari F2003 GA was a highly successful car used by Scuderia Ferrari in the 2003 Formula One World Championship. It was introduced partway through the season and was driven by Michael Schumacher and Rubens Barrichello, securing both championship titles that year. Immerse yourself in a gastronomic experience that combines a passion for motors with culinary sophistication.
Thank you. Get back.